As students at Purdue University, we experience the transportation problems firsthand. Although we all agree that the transportation system has a good foundation, we believe it needs to be improved and built upon in order to accommodate the influx of future students. As of right now, the busing system seems to be fine, but for students, it has a giant flaw. If you have a late class or a late test and you want to use the bus system, you'll be left standing in the dark. Another factor is the schedule. It's only available online and in print on the buses. However, the schedule is confusing to read and understand. The biking situation is easier to fix, though. The problem with the biking is that there isn't enough bike racks and the paths aren't clearly marked. Also, there are only a few bike paths around campus, forcing bikers to ride on the sidewalks, intermingling with the pedestrians, which is prohibited. The biggest problem with the Purdue transportation is their lack of parking for commuter students. I personally have spent 45 minutes trying to find a parking spot, only to be late for my class. As we will show, there are various problems that can be fixed, and with the future incoming students, it has to be taken into consideration and the foundation needs to be built upon.
The public transportation of Purdue, the only means of transportation for many students, is in need of some serious uplifting and new additions. Though it is functional and gets the job done, it is very basic, with buses that run at certain times for only a portion of the day. It's not enough for the average student, and this disparity in what a student needs and what they are receiving from the transportation services is what forces them to purchase a car and solve the transportation problems themselves. With this rapid increase of the number of cars on campus, the number of appropriate parking spots has to increase proportionally, but this simply isn't happening. Due to Purdue's priority system, where the faculty and the graduate student get most of the acceptable parking, the undergraduate student is left with almost nothing. Undergraduate students are told to park at either the airport or stadium parking, which is just simply too far from class. And I feel that it is just ridiculous for anyone to suggest to a student to park their car miles from class and then force them to walk or take the bus when the whole point of getting the car was to become immune from the troubles of Purdue's public transportation. With the assigned Purdue parking pretty much irrelevant, undergraduate students are forced into places like Russell Street to fight over the limited amount of free parking that is offered, since it's closer to classes. Our research indicates that if Purdue's transportation remains this way, it will only lead to more and more illegal parkings and more people crowding places like Russell Street. Something must be done to change the system now before it completely goes out of hand and results in a very dangerous and very inefficient future for Purdue.
The bus system is an important aspect of the transportation at Purdue. It carries hundreds of students to and around campus and other parts of West Lafayette. The website College Prowler is filled with student reviews of the entire transportation system. The specific reviews of the buses praise them for what they accomplish. They carry several students at a quick pace during peak commuting hours, which is 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. Although CityBus does an above-average job at transporting students, other parts of the system can be improved. all of the bus stops should have shelter to protect from the elements. Bus signs merely say City Bus Stop with contact information. They can include maps of each route of the buses and detailed schedules. To prevent students from missing the buses, systems like Bus Catcher can be implemented. Bus Catcher is a GPS system for smartphones that warns users when a bus is arriving. It includes a map for detailed routes.
I'm talking about bike parking problems. First, I will show the Santa Monica's bike parking problems. The school does a pretty substandard job of accommodating bikes. It is a typical example and can compare with our school's problems. Secondly, I took some pictures in front of Harrison Hall. You can see that many bikes hanging in the trees in a mess. The picture ironically shows that people don't have enough spaces for parking bike. I think it is not just a simple prank. And at last, I took some pictures in front of a Helen brand. The bike is all is parking fall down and in a mess. It will show that the school provides fewer parking spaces for bikes.
These landmarks and the buildings surrounding them define Purdue University's campus and set us apart from other colleges. They preserve the rich history and hold the many memories of alum and current students alike. Yet, many of these landmarks lie within the campus where cars and buses can only get so close and bike paths do not reach. Though it makes sense that the roads are not tearing through campus, why are there not more accessible bike lanes? Many times, these lanes do not even stretch to the bike racks, meaning bikers must venture onto roads and sidewalks, risking injury and penalization.
I'm John Michael. I used to ride my bike around Purdue's campus. About 2 months ago, I got a $30 ticket for riding my bike on the sidewalk. I was riding my bike on the sidewalk because I was in the road one time and this guy almost hit me and started yelling at me for being in the road, even though it's against the law for us to be on the sidewalks on Purdue's campus. And so now I just don't ride my bike anymore. I don't feel it's worth it because I don't think it's safe to ride my bike in the road. And I really don't want another $30 ticket.
As you can see, the transportation system has flaws and needs to be worked upon, but it does have a good start. The bus system is convenient for many people and does its job effectively. The bike lanes offer an alternative way to get around campus and faster way to get there. Parking helps commuter students get to campus and allows the students to live off campus and not in the dorms. Although these are good things, they will become obsolete in the future if the bad things are not taken care of now.
Good evening. Here is the news. We wanna ride.